Wire management is simply the process of making your wiring neat and organized so that it shows good workmanship and makes tracing wires for future troubleshooting easier. And that's exactly what I'm going to cover today in lesson number 11 of this wire terminals playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, there's no one right answer to wire management. In this video, I'm just going to share a couple of the products that I personally use for wire management and what I like to use them for so that you have some insight for how you can potentially incorporate them into your own system installation. Let's get started. Zip ties. I don't think I need to explain why zip ties are useful. If you don't already know why zip ties are useful, you probably shouldn't be installing an electrical system. Just get them from Amazon in a bag of 1,000. It's cheaper than going to your local hardware store, and you're going to use them, if not for your electrical system, for other things. Wire loom. I use two different types of wire loom. I use split loom and braided loom. So split loom is a bit bulkier and it sort of looks a little bit worse, but it actually probably offers a little bit more abrasion protection. And this stuff is pretty great for installing wires underneath a truck for DC to DC charging, where bulk and looks really don't matter that much. Now, braided loom requires us to feed wire in from the ends, which is sort of a bit of a pain, but it looks super nice by the time it's all said and done. You know, especially if you clean the ends up with a bit of heat shrink like I've done here. And this also offers a fair amount of abrasion protection whenever wires could rub together, but maybe not as much abrasion protection as split loom from sharp edges and such. Now, wire loom comes in several different diameters, so you'll just need to see how thick your bundle of wires are and then get the loom to match. Cable duct. Now, you've seen cable duct on our channel a few times. It has these little fingers on the sides that can be broken off to put wires through and a lid that snaps into place to conceal wires from view, keep things from bumping into them, and it can be cut to fit with any kind of saw, which I think a miter saw works best here and makes the most square cut. Now it's a bit extra, if you will, but it definitely makes an installation look super nice. I'll leave a link in the video description of where we get ours. Cable clamps. Cable clamps simply go around one or more wires and then hold the wires in place with a screw. Now, I personally like these ones with a little bit of a rubberized coating on them, and these come in many different sizes depending on what size of wire or what size of bundles of wires that you're working with. Zip tie squares. If you need to secure a wire or a bundle of wires to something similar to a cable clamp, you can use a zip tie square. These just screw to where you need the wire secured, and then the zip tie just sort of feeds through like that. And then the wires are secured to the mounting square with the zip tie. Now, most of these have some double-sided tape on the back of them. It's kind of finicky, and it honestly isn't that sticky. So just go ahead and bank on needing to put a screw through that hole to secure it to whatever you're mounting it to. Now, wire management does a few different things. It makes your installation more professional looking. It holds your wires in place to decrease abrasion to the insulation. It adds strain relief to a component connection, reducing the chance that the wire will fall out. And it allows you to easily trace wires for troubleshooting purposes. Now, we're going to be doing wire management on all of the wires throughout the rest of this academy, so be sure to bookmark this lesson for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher, because going forward, I'll just assume that you know what all of this is and how to keep your wires nice and tidy.